it's a fascinating exploration into some of the strategies that you could personally employ to improve your metabolic efficiency and your overall health. So welcome, and thank you for joining us today, Scott.
Hey, thanks for having me. It's great to be here.
So you have a very interesting book, and it basically focuses the large part of it on Wim Hof. And I was intrigued with his work, but he has a very thick Danish accent, and it's, as you know, difficult to communicate with. And I heard your interview with Ben Greenfield and was very impressed with your ability to articulate some of his philosophies. But not only did you do that, you actually explored his training and sort of giving away the surprise at the end of the book, but you actually climbed Mount Kilimanjaro, the highest mountain in Africa. Not only did you climb it, you climbed it in shoes and shorts, shirtless for most of the way. Not only did you do it that, but you did it in record time, like in 28 hours, faster than anyone's ever done it before.
Well, that's not quite true, but I did it very fast. The fastest ascent ever was actually 6 hours by
wow.
a person who had acclimatized themselves to the altitude previously.
Okay.
So an ultra-runner person. But the thing that was amazing about our ascent is that we did it without any acclimation, which is something that is basically unheard of. It usually takes about 5 to 10 days to get to the top.
Yeah, and you had consulted with some, I believe, a military expert who were really skilled in making projections and predictions as to how many people would develop altitude sickness and have to turn back, and they did like 80-90%. And why don't you comment on that?
Yeah, so the U.S. AERIUM, which is the environmental unit for the U.S. Army, has really advanced tables for high-altitude ascents. And they predicted that 70% of us would come down with acute mountain sickness, which is where your blood oxygen level is so low that you go starting at headaches to swollen limbs to cardiac arrest, pulmonary embolism, death. And they predicted that we would have 70% come down with that condition. Instead, about 92-93% of us made it up to the top. And the first group where I was in, we did it in 28 hours, which is incredibly fast.
All right, so that's a powerful testimony to the physiological benefits of the strategies that Wim is teaching. And you didn't come into this as actually an advocate of this approach. You came in to debunk him as a radical skeptic and thought he was harming people. So why don't you take us through that journey?
Sure. Well, so I'm an investigative journalist, and over the course of my career, I've examined a lot of sort of false gurus, people who make really advanced spiritual claims and occasionally end with people dying or getting hurt, losing all their money, that sort of thing. Now, when I heard about Wim Hof, I thought that he was going to be another very sketchy guru, because his claims were that he could control his body temperature at will, consciously control his autonomic nervous system and his immune system. He has the record for an Arctic marathon barefoot in his shorts. He's done marathons in the Sahara. He's hiked two-thirds up the way Mount Everest, also in his shorts. And so I knew he had some of these abilities. He'd had a history with this. However, what I worried was that when he claims that he can teach these things, what might be his innate biological abilities are really the false claims that could get someone killed. So I had a assignment to go there and write about his training. So he meets me at the airport. We're in Wrocław. This is the Polish winter. I like to say it's the same winter that stopped the Nazi army. It's the same winter that Napoleon turned his armies around. And here I am. I'm taking a cab with him into the mountains of that area. And he says basically that in a couple days I'll be standing out in my shorts and a shirt and heating myself up consciously and have no trouble. So I say, okay, I'm going to try your method for a few days. And the second that I start feeling this is sketchy, that this is no good, I'm out. And it turns out things are pretty cool. And maybe that's why a couple hours later I said, okay, I'm going to give his whole shirtless snow thing a chance. And I strip off all my clothes. Basically, I'm in the underwear. And I walk out, and I put my feet in the snow for the first time. And I'll tell you what, Doc, it hurt.
How cold was it?
Oh, I mean, we're probably talking 25 degrees Fahrenheit. I put my feet in the snow, and it felt like walking over hot coals. And what's happening there is, you know, you're triggering this response in your body called vasoconstriction. So the arteries in your feet will squinch shut to push the blood to the core. So it hurt. In 5 minutes, it was super painful. And then, you know, we jump into a sauna right after that. And in the process of vasodilation, which is where your arteries open up, that hurt even more. And I was like, Wim, this is a horrible, terrible method. Why are you teaching this? And he's like, yeah, of course it's going to hurt. You've never done this before. But just wait till tomorrow. By the end of the week, I'm standing in the snow in my shorts, sweating in this Polish winter, and I'm there for an hour, and there's no problem. At the end of that journey, you know, with him, I hike up a mountain in Poland, again, wearing just shorts in the middle of the blowing winter. We're talking about 2 degrees Fahrenheit. I'm on the mountain for 8 hours, and I just sweat the whole time. And I realized that Wim wasn't offering superpowers, right? He was offering human powers. He was offering things that humans have an innate ability to adapt to the environment around us. And all he was doing was giving me a method to learn how to control some of these processes in my body.
An interesting journey indeed, and you turn from a skeptic into an avid believer.